Hi everyone, my name is Alex Lapides and I'm a first year student at Moss Landing Marine Labs. And I'll be showing you around our beautiful campus as well as talking about some of the research that's happening in our labs. As you all know, COVID has put a damper on many activities and MLML has significantly reduced its in-person access to comply with safety regulations. However, that hasn't stopped our dedicated students and faculty from conducting ambitious research amidst this historical crisis. Let's take a look at what these labs have to offer and what they've been up to during 2020.
The Ichthyology Lab is one of the largest at Moss Landing Marine Labs. It is home to Dr. Scott Hamilton, his graduate students, and several affiliated researchers, both at Moss Landing Marine Labs and at collaborating institutions, where they study the ecology of marine fishes and reef communities. Studies in the Ichthyology Lab include climate change effects on rock fishes, predator-prey interactions, direct and indirect effects of fishing on communities, foraging ecology, and life history studies. Much of the current work is focused on temperate and coral reef fishes from off the coast of California and around the world. Let's hear from a few Ichthyology Lab students, starting with myself.
Hi, my name is Kameron. I am co-advised by James Lindholm at CSUMB, as well as Scott Hamilton in the Ichthyology Lab. And my thesis involves studying fish communities using 360-degree cameras, such as this one. These cameras are really interesting because they see everything in all directions at once. So it can be particularly helpful if you're trying to see what fish at the canopy of a kelp forest are doing, as well as the fish at the very bottom of the reef. These cameras only became small enough and cheap enough for us to take underwater efficiently very recently. So we think it's a very novel idea, and we're some of the first people to actually swim these cameras along a reef to do fish transects. Overall, we think 360-degree cameras may give us a really unique opportunity to study fish communities in California.
Hi, I'm Grace, and I'm in the Ichthyology Lab at MLML. I study the impacts of declining oxygen levels on juvenile flatfish in Elkhorn Slough, and I'm gearing up for a busy field season this summer. For my research, I will be placing cages of flatfish in the slough and monitoring their growth and survivorship along a natural oxygen gradient.
The Invertebrate Ecology Lab combines ship-based, field, and laboratory studies to understand how invertebrates interact with, affect, and are affected by their surrounding environment.
Hey, my name is Travis. I'm co-advised by James Lindholm at CSUMB and Amanda Kahn in the Invertebrate Ecology Lab, and I am studying the effects of reef contiguity on urchin and giant kelp populations in the Carmel Bay. So my research is focusing a lot on urchin and kelp forest interactions. This is obviously a really important thing given our current ocean climate, where we're losing kelp forests up and down the California coast, particularly in Northern California. And so hopefully my research will shed some light on where potential kelp refuges may exist away from the reaches of these pretty voracious grazers. Today, we're going to be doing some stereo video and transect surveys on the north side of the Carmel Bay, otherwise known as North Monastery. The two cameras across from each other let us measure distance and size as opposed to a single lens, which doesn't give you any of that depth perspective. So today I'll be using this, and Denise will be conducting photo quadrant surveys with the camera on the tailgate. And that gives us an archive and a way to quickly assess the habitat down there and the community composition.
Hello, my name is Jackson Hecke, a member of the Invertebrate Ecology Lab here at Moss Landing. I'm studying the invasive sponge hymeniacidon in the Elkhorn Slough, and I'm hoping that by looking at its seasonal life cycle, we can understand the impacts of this invader on one of our local ecosystems.
Hi, my name is Alex Lapides, and I am currently a graduate student in the Invertebrate Ecology Lab, led by Dr. Amanda Kahn. For my thesis, I am studying an animal called the siphonophore. These guys are closely related to common jellyfish, but they're colonial organisms, so they're a floating colony that lives in the midwater. Not a lot is known about them, and for my project, I'm looking at what siphonophores eat and what sort of dietary specializations they have. This information is really important moving forward because it allows us to make more informed decisions about management and conservation of the ecosystem in which they live. The Phycology Lab at MLML studies the physiology, ecology, and evolutionary biology of seaweeds and their associated communities.
Hi, my name is Bennett. I'm a second year in the Phycology Lab here at Moss Landing. For my thesis, I'll be exploring how density affects bull kelp's morphology and physiology across its life history. Bull kelp's life history is super interesting in that it's an annual and it exists in super harsh, wave-exposed localities. Getting a greater understanding on how density affects bull kelp's life history and its survivability will help fill in the research gaps for bull kelp throughout its geographic range, because as many divers know, the past year we've seen great reduction in bull kelp's abundances throughout the West Coast.